Good morning, my dear children. Welcome back to our maths class. In our previous video, we started our chapter multiplication and we learned how to construct multiplication tables using repeated addition. In today's video, let us move on to the next method of construction of multiplication tables using skip counting. Now let us see how to do that. So, forming multiplication tables using skip counting. So, let us see how to do the table of 2 using skip counting. So, first we need to start for the table of 2, we need to start from the first number 2 here. So, after 2, we need to do skip counting by 2s. Okay. So, which means first is number 2. After that, we need to skip counting by 2. So, 1, 2. So, we will circle this number. So, after this, again 1, 2. So, every second number, we need to circle it. So, after this, 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. So we have done skip counting by 2 and circled all these numbers. Now let us write it as the table. So first is 1 times 2. So 1 times 2 is 2. So after that, 2 times. 2 times 2 is 4. Next is 1, 2, 3. So 3 times 2 is 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 times 2 is 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 times 2 is 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here we have done skip counting by 6 times. Okay, so 6 times 2 is 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 times 2 is 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 times 2 is 16. Next is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 times 2 is how much? 18. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So 10 times 2 is 20. So children, we have done skip counting by 2s and then written multiplication table of 2. So this is how we do skip counting. Now let us learn how to do multiplication tables or how to form multiplication tables using sticks. Here I have drawn these lines. These lines represent the sticks. Now let us understand how to form multiplication table of 3 using these sticks or stick method. Okay, so I have drawn, as we are doing the table of 3, we have taken 3 sticks here, 3 horizontal sticks here. So the first one, for 1 time, so 1 times 3, so we need to place one more stick vertically like this. Okay, so after this we need to mark the points where this stick and these sticks meet against each other. So here is 1 point, here is 2 and here is 3. So 1 times 3 is 1, 2, 3. So this is how we are going to form the table of 3 using this sticks. Okay, for 2 times, we need to place one more stick here and then again mark the points where they are meeting. So we have marked this. Now let us count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 2 times 2 times 3 is 6. Okay. For third one, we need to place one more stick here and then again mark the points. We need to mark the points where these sticks and these sticks intersect or meet. So now let us count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So how many sticks have we placed here? 1, 2 and 3. So 3 times here, how many sticks do we have? 1, 2, 3. So 3 times 3 is 3 times 3 is 9. Next, fourth stick and then again mark the points and then count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 4 times 3 is 12. Now let's go for the fifth one. So we have taken one more stick here and then mark the points where it meets. Now count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So we have counted 15. So how many sticks do we have placed? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 times 1, 2, 3. 3 times. 5 times 3 is 15. Now let us go for the sixth one. We are placing a sixth stick here and then mark the points. Now count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So 6 times 3 is 18. Now let's go for the 7th one. And then mark the points where it meets. Now count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So 7 times 3 is 21. Now let us place the 8th stick and then mark the points and then count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So 8 times 3 is 24. Now next is 9. So let us place the 9th stick and then mark the points. Then count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26 and 27. So 9 times 3 is 27. Now let's place the 10th stick and then mark the points. Now let us start counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29 and 30. So 10 times 3 is 30. So this is the method where we form the tables using sticks. So we have formed the table of 3. In the same way, we can form the tables of all the numbers. Okay. So as we have learned how to construct multiplication tables using 3 methods. The first one was repeated addition. The second one was using skip counting. And the third one is using sticks. So whatever method that we follow to construct the tables, and as you can see, in some places it will be written as 1 into 3 or 1 multiplied by 3. So we get the answer as 3. So it is the same if we write it as 3 into 1. That is also 3. So if we write as 1 multiplied by 3 or 3 multiplied by 1, both are same. The same is for all the numbers. For example, if you say 2 multiplied by 3 is 6, it is the same if we write it as 3 multiplied by 2, this is also the same. The same, the product will be the same. So you need not get confused when you see as 1 into 3 is also 3 or 3 into 1 is also 3. So we can write it in either ways. Now let us learn the properties of multiplication. We have 3 properties of multiplication. The first one is the product of 2 numbers remains the same even after changing the order of the numbers. So that's just now I told you, if we write 3 times 2 or 2 times 3, the product will be the same. So after multiplying, the answer that we get is called as the product, right? So the product of 2 numbers remains the same even after changing the order of the numbers. As you can see here, I have written 3 into 2 or 3 multiplied by 2 here, and here 2 multiplied by 3. So these two will give the same answer or the product. So 3 times 2 is 6 and 2 times 3 is also 6. So if we get in either format, the product will be the same. So this is the first property of multiplication. The second one is, when a number is multiplied by 1, the product is the number itself. So any number multiplied by 1 will give the product as the number itself. So any number multiplied by 1 will give the product as the number itself. So here we have 12 multiplied by 1. We will get 12 as the product. So this is the second property of multiplication, where a number which is multiplied by 1 will give the same number as the product. And the third property is, when a number is multiplied by 0, the product is always 0. So as we saw here, any number multiplied by 1 will give the number itself. Here, any number multiplied by 0 will give the product or the answer as 0. So 10 into 0 will give the product as 0. 7 into 0 is also 0. So these are the 3 properties of multiplication that we have seen today. So even though we have different methods, we learned 3 methods of construction of tables. The first one was by using repeated addition. The second one was by using skip counting. And the third one we learned by using sticks. Okay. Even though we have 3 methods to construct the tables, we need to learn the tables by heart to do the sums very easily. Okay. So I want you all to learn the multiplication tables by heart, and let us meet in our next video.